Here today I have a FPV 250 and a mini tricopter by SimpleCopter.com. And I'm just going to go over some of the differences that I've experienced between these two different multi-rotors and the kind of things that you can expect if you fly these as well. I'll start with the FPV 250 because that's probably what most people are familiar with. This has a D4R2 receiver, a NAS A32 board. It has the DYS 1806 motors on it, and I'm running the 3-blade 5x3 propellers. These are probably the most common propeller sizes, the 5x3. The 3-blades are a little less common than just the 2-blade, but with the 3-blade propellers, I feel like I get a lot more lift, or at least a noticeable amount of lift from it. This one I've been flying with it for quite a while. Oh, I also have the tracker inside there in case it gets lost out in the field. But this is a pretty good quadcopter. I got 12 amp ESCs on it. They're Afro ESCs. And then it flies real well, and I've had real good luck with it, and I've made a few videos with it flying through my neighborhood. And it, like I said, this thing has been real fun. This is the mini tricopter from SimpleCopter.com. It has the KK2 board right up here on top with some anti-vibration foam tape. It has 12 amp magic ESCs inside the plates here. Here's one of them right there. You can kind of make it out. And it has the Sunny Sky motors on it. And these were all recommended by Matt Hall in his build video. And it also is running 6x4x5 propellers on it. Now, there's no FPV gear on here because I don't have another set to put on it. Oh, this one also has a rear servo on it. These servos are about $7, you know, and some people are scared of tricopters because of this rear servo, but this thing has some definite advantages, and I'll talk about those in a little bit. I have the wires zip tied on here. I have a battery feed going down here so the KK2 board can read the voltage. I have a piezo alarm right here with the low voltage alarm set to 10 volts. And this single cable here is the CPPM cable that goes to the receiver out here in the front. And again, this is a D4R2 receiver as well. Now the receiver, I was able to run one antenna right back here out the back arm so that it lays level. And then I got the other one here standing up inside the little plastics antenna sleeve. That should allow it to have good reception no matter which angle the tricopter is facing. The difference is with this one, you can do this. You can run this antenna inside the board because this is wood, and wood doesn't mess up your receiver antennas. Now, if this were made of carbon fiber, then you would have, whenever it went like this, and your receiver is sitting here pointing like this, it can't hardly even see this antenna at all because of the carbon fiber plates. But because it's wood, it's not an issue. The battery on the bottom is Velcroed on, just like Matt Hall recommended in his video. The biggest difference between a mini quad and a mini tricopter is the yaw servo on the back end of this. This one over here, the FPV 250, does not have any yaw servos on it. It just has the four propellers. And so to turn this way, you know, to yaw like this, what it does, it actually spins up two propellers faster than the other two, and that creates centrifugal force, which allows the quadcopter to yaw back and forth. Now, the bad thing about that is that when the two motors here, like these two here, they spin up, the quadcopter will sometimes go up because the propellers are spinning faster, and the other two slow down a little bit to try to help it from not going up. But it, nevertheless, the thing still goes up a little bit when it starts to yaw. Now on a tricopter, that does not happen. What happens is the three propellers all spin the same, and the yaw servo back here in the back tilts just enough that it pulls it back into the tricopter around one way or the other. And these propellers don't have to spin up faster or slow down to counter that movement. And you can hear it when this one spins around, you give it a full yaw, you can hear it go zoom, and it really spins up. This one here, when you give it full yaw, you just see the back motor just tilt and the thing starts to spin like a top. It's pretty neat. Woo! Almost hit the camera. Another big difference between these multi-rotors is this one has 5-inch propellers, and that's as big as it can fit, and they barely clear the cage here. You can probably get 5x4s and get a little different kind of performance, but the 5x4s perform about identically to the 5x3 3-blade propellers. Now if you got 5x4 by 3-blade propellers, you'd probably see a big difference there. But for For this one, though, this 5-inch propellers is the biggest it can have when it has this cage on here. This one, of course, has 6-inch propellers, and it can even have more. This antenna I just put here so I would have better reception on my receiver, but there's still enough room here. You could probably run 7-inch propellers on this thing, and it still would be okay. Now, if you go 7-inch propellers, you might want to drop down to a 2S battery with the Sunny Skies, but the 6-inch propellers provide a lot more lift for this tricopter, and it becomes a lot more responsive in the air when you try to, if you just kind of tap the throttle, like up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. This thing really gets a lot of up and down movements, where this one here, it will go up and down. It's just a little slower to respond because of the thrust that these propellers provide. These Sunny Sky motors on the mini tricopter also are a 2004 size, so they're a little bit bigger round than the DYS motors. The DYS motor is a little bit smaller, and the only thing that provides is usually if you have bigger bells, I think they have a little bit better torque to them. It doesn't necessarily make them spin fast, but they can usually handle bigger propellers and higher voltage batteries without breaking. And these are 1806. Whoops. And these are 1806 size. You can see it there. Even though it's not a fair comparison to compare the weight differences between these two, I'm going to go ahead and do it anyway because I know someone's going to ask. So this one is the, like I said, it's the FPV 250. It does have the Mobius. It does have the front-facing camera. It has the video transmitter. It's a Boscam TS3 832, I think. And let's see what it weighs. It comes in at 447.9 grams, and that's pretty good. When you have a mini quad like this, you want to come in under 500 if you can. And here's a, I'll throw on this 1500 battery on here, and we'll see what it weighs with the battery on it as well. With the battery, it comes in at 578.8 grams. So here's the mini tricopter, and of course it doesn't have any FPV gear on it, but we're gonna go ahead and weigh it anyway and see what it comes in at. With no FPV gear, this is weighing in at 338.8 grams. If we throw a battery on here, it goes up to 469.7. And that's pretty standard. This is a pretty standard layout for the way Matt Hall recommends that it be built. The only thing I did differently was I only ran the one cable to the receiver because I'm using CPPM, and I got another video that shows how to set that up with the KK2 board. And the other thing I did is on the landing gear, it comes with a bump here and a little bump here, probably for some other helicopter. I went ahead and I shaved those off because when it was causing the landing gear to bend inward like this, and when it landed, it had a lot of spring to it and it'd bounce over upside down. I cut those little bumps off, and now it lays out a little flatter. When it lands, the landing gear spreads out a little bit more and makes for a little bit safer or softer landing, and it doesn't bounce over like it was. Another thing to mention is I've been using this Taranis for the better part of a month. It replaced a Turnigy 9X, and this is awesome. If you don't have one of these, you should buy it because they're awesome. Anyway, back to this. This is the mini tricopter from simplecopter.com. This is the FPV 250, and this has just been a small comparison between them. If you have any questions about this, let me know in the comments and I'll try to answer them as best I can. I'm going to get some FPV gear for this because I just love these propellers and I love the yaw. Everything about this is really fun. And I started on a tricopter and I really have missed it since I switched over to quadcopters, mostly mini quads. But now that I have this mini tricopter, I'm really looking forward to it again. If you don't have one, if you're considering getting one, I'd say go ahead and get one and give Matt a little bit of support. And if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. And if you got, like I said before, if you have any questions, put them in the comments. I'll try to answer them as best I can. And thanks for watching. Woo, almost hit the camera.